Sanborn Field was established 130 years ago, and what farmers were noticing was that their yields were decreasing, and they didn't know why or how to stop it. So they established these plots in 1888. Well, it was so successful, 130 years later, we're still doing this. So we've learned a lot just by simple rotations, how that can affect crop yield. This is the famous plot 17 that has never had any fertility on it since 1888 and has been in continuous corn. And you look at it, it's not even up to my chest hardly. This is a sister plot to plot 17. Again, continuous corn, 1888, but the difference is it's had 6 tons of manure applied every year. We do have more yield, but it's still not very good because it's a continuous corn. We've never had that break. Now, I showed you plots 17 and 18, continuous corn since 1888. These are some sister plots to them in that these plots were also established in 1888, but there's one difference. They have a 3-year rotation of corn, wheat, and red clover. Now you notice there's no soybeans. Why? They didn't grow soybeans in 1888. That came a little bit later. So just because of that rotation effect, we've got much, much better corn. This plot is the same that we saw before with a three-year rotation of corn, wheat, and red clover, but instead of having 6 tons of manure, it has full fertility, meaning N, P, and K. This full fertility corn would show drought stress, meaning that these leaves would twist up to avoid the sun, whereas that with the 6 tons of manure did not. So that was really fascinating, and we can't wait to see what the yield differences will be this year. Again, this is corn from 1888, but instead of being continuous corn and no fertility, this is a 3-year rotation with no fertility. Corn, wheat, and red clover. And look at the difference in the size of the ears. They are quite a bit larger. They're still not as full as our full fertility or our manures, but at least the yields here are much greater. All right, now this is some of those treatments that got modified in 1928. Soybeans were coming into the marketplace by that time. They were still not used for their grain, but instead they were more of a forage crop. So this rotation is corn, soybean, wheat, and red clover. So now we've got two legumes mixed in here with different fertility treatments. This is that 4-year rotation and full fertility. Again, it looks very good corn, you know, full NPK. So that looks very, very nice. Now this plot is the same 4-year rotation, corn, soybean, wheat, red clover, full fertility except no potassium. Now potassium is very important for drought stress. And when we look at the ears, they're still pretty good. They filled out fairly well. But what was interesting this summer was that when you came out here in the morning, this corn plot was often water stressed. The leaves were rolled up while that of the full fertility was not. Because potassium is so important in regulating drought stress. Now, this again with the same 4-year rotation of corn, soybean, wheat, and red clover, except this time it's full fertility except for phosphorus. And what you notice is that the ears aren't filled out near as well as the full fertility or even the potassium, and the ears are much lighter. Now, we're with that same 4-year rotation of corn, soybean, wheat, and red clover. Instead of having commercial fertilizers, we have manures. They're filled out to the tip, much, much greater. They're a heavier, bigger kernel. Again, it's a lot like our full fertility, but possibly just a little bit better. Now, again, we're in that 4-year rotation. This is comparable to plot 17, meaning no fertilizer, but the big thing, instead of having continuous corn or a 3-year rotation, we've got a 4-year rotation this time, including soybeans. It's much better. It's not near as good as our full fertility or our manures, but just because of the rotation and the N2 fixation, we have a decent corn yield. What's famous about these plots is that Dr. Albrecht took a soil sample from this low fertility plot, never even fertilizer, in the mid-1940s, and sent it in, and this is where Oreomycin was discovered. This antibiotic was used throughout animal agriculture in the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, into the mid-80s as a primary source of antibiotics. And as a result, it has saved farmers millions, if not billions, of dollars over that time. This is a very unique plot here at Sanborn Field. This is the only no-till plot. They established this in 1971, and it's probably the oldest continuous no-till plot here in Missouri. And what we always find, usually, is that in a dry summer, that the no-till corn would do better than the conventional. Overall, it's about the same, but in dry years, there's a big difference. This was the exception. They couldn't figure out why, in dry years, that this plot of no-till corn did worse than the conventional ones. But one day, the manager that took care of this stood on top of his pickup truck and looked out, and he saw this ring out in the middle of this plot of the corn being stretched out. Then he looked across the street and saw a huge bur oak tree. Aha! What's happening? Those bur oak roots that went under the road and up into this plot, and they're sucking all the moisture out. So the very next day they came out and they severed those roots with a backhoe, and ever since then, this plot has behaved just like the rest of them. In dry years like we had this year, it will probably make more than the conventional till plot. So Sanborn Field is unlocking secrets from 130 years ago. So I think it's really neat. As we have more and more modern techniques, we can find out what we have observed and how that really affects everything.